But
like in spades, you want spades. In spades, you want all the spades. In hearts, you don't want the hearts. And you definitely don't want the queen of hearts, because that's the worst one. Like how everybody wants the joker in spades. Mm-hmm.
That's not ringing a bell.
If you play it, you'll understand.
I like 52 card pickup. That shit hard.
Oh, hell no.
Yeah, you I'm just an asshole. You're going to be the dumbass picking this shit up.
I really want a theme song for this podcast.
Bro, I've been said that shit. But, you know.
I was chilling with a young lady the other day. Shouts out to her. And we was just chilling. And then she just came out of nowhere. Shut up. We just came out of nowhere and she was like, "What's in my bag? Nigga, what's in my bag? Hey." And at first it was kind of annoying. So I was like, "What the fuck is she doing?" Then as she kept repeating it, I was like, "What's in my bag? Nigga, what's in my bag? What's in my bag? What's in?" I was like, could I have like a whole like click of like ratchet gangster? I was going to say the word, but I can't. Ratchet gangster women to like say that and it would be cool. I don't know, like I just want to take this thing to the next level, but whatever.
That's really crazy. It took her to do that shit for you to consider that,
because I mean, other than nobody else really like, what am I trying to say, fuck it, whatever. The ideas just don't come that frequently. So when they do come and they do hit, I want to capitalize on that. So,
bro, I think that's something I'm gonna do. I literally said that.
Well, I don't know, bro. You might want to try to get on the shit and like rap on it. I don't know, bro. Shit.
Jesus,
that's not Christ.
This nigga swear he getting high off that little vape. Man, if you don't get that weak shit out of here. Oh, my God. Let's get this podcast. What's up? Uh-oh.
I was going to say something about the, I mean, I think a song would be pretty good because it's consistent. But at the same time, I like when you pick songs because you set the mood.
Now, see, I'm thinking of like a theme song for maybe like promotional uses, because I'm still going to stay with this shit, just playing shit like shit that we all love. Maybe not Jhde, because he doesn't really have any musical like background. He doesn't really care about classics. Hey, he just really doesn't vibe.
I want to do a music appreciation, you know what I'm saying?
For who?
Bro, trust me, bro. I swear to God, bro. I promise you, bro. It's not going to be who you think it is. I want to do a music appreciation, bro. So
that's interesting. Lay it to me, and I'll mix it. I'll figure it out.
No,
you just don't want to tell me.
Yeah, like, I want to do it.
Oh, like now.
I mean, not necessarily now, but
in the show.
All right. Shit. Episode 50. Wait, where are we at? 56. If you in your car, if you at work, turn this shit up. Turn this shit up. Playing classics. It's all because of you. It's all because of you.
It is your fault for that.
I was like, I'm not gonna say that part. I've led to a lot of the sadness.
Hold on, what is this leading on to?
Bro, we just making jokes, man. It's a podcast. Oh my God, how long you been doing this shit? Tired of this nigga, man.
He does not like nothing but love.
Hey, listen, you leaving the show next. It's gonna be me and Sadia.
Oh no, you are not gonna get rid of Jhde.
I'm so full of shit. Happy birthday, Kevin. 29, 29. Happy birthday.
I got it,
yeah. Hey.
I don't like when y'all make those jokes. That's not nice.
Really?
Yeah.
That's what I do. I can't make those jokes.
Don't pick with nobody.
He's doing great. Happy birthday, Kev. Yo, old ass. All right, back to the music. Hey. It's hot as fuck. Oh, shit.
Bro, how are you hot?
You're not hot.
No.
I'm glad y'all not hot. I was actually gonna cancel the show. I'll talk about it. Turn this shit up, turn this shit up. We back. Another week. I wanna say bitches so bad.
All right, everybody get one time to say it. Go ahead.
You ready? We're gonna say with the ES at the end. You ready?
No, I'm a whole mind for later on in the episode.
Let's okay, cool.
One time. Everybody get one time to say it.
I like that. Hey. Oh, y'all can come in. Shit. Welcome to the What's in My Bag podcast. It is me, your host, Louis B. I'm joined by some friends, none other than Jade. Speak to him, my guy.
Yep.
Sadia, speak to him, my gal.
What's up?
Yes, sir. Episode 50 motherfucking 6. Oh. I'm happy to be here. I'm happy to be doing this thing again. Not gonna lie to you niggas. We're more than likely gonna be taking a break after this week for an undisclosed amount of time. We're moving and figuring some things out. So give me time. And yeah, hopefully this podcast is gonna hold y'all over until. So how's everybody's weeks, man? Talk to me.
You go first.
Oh my God!
I always make the woman go first.
Ladies first. What you mean? Okay.
Looking all. How you looking? Look at. You see the clarity?
Don't hype me.
You see
don't
the clarity? The baby. How you pronounce baby? BB.
BB.
Oh, I ain't got no money. I don't know how to pronounce that shit. What's going on with you, Sadia? You good?
Yeah, I'm pretty cool. This week has been real smooth.
Real smooth shit. Mm-hmm. Good. What about you?
Hey, man.
Huh?
I finally, I had to check back up with the airport, so I'm about to get down.
No, you're not.
Damn, nigga.
Ain't no more.
Shit, she's turning on me.
Ain't no more warehouse shit, man.
Good.
Fuck that shit, bro.
Good. I hope that goes well.
About to get these flights in, you know what I'm saying?
Now, that is the perk of doing any airport-type job. I don't care if it's for fucking Spirit. If y'all giving me free flights, I am there.
I'm getting the fuck up out of this motherfucker, you know what I'm saying? Hey, bro. No, for real. First trip will be California, bro.
God damn it. You take away the purpose of the pot. I was literally going to ask you that, and you just answered it. Good. So, shit. Where would be your second trip? You already gave me your first.
I don't know. I didn't even think about it.
With a job like that, shit, on your off day, you can say, all right, fuck it. I'm doing shit at the crib. Let me just go. Mm-hmm. Let me just go to somewhere. Let me just go to Houston. Oh, I want to go to Texas so bad. Mm-hmm. I hear that they just made differently out there. Jade, you know what I'm talking about. But anyway, yeah. It's been a long-ass week.
This nigga here.
It's been a long ass week, man. The apartment motherfuckers done cut off the AC. Yo, I guess now that you get older, you start, huh?
They don't give a fuck about y'all.
And you don't realize that shit until you get older. You start to just realize a lot of different things that you may not have understood when you were younger, like changes in management. Mm-hmm. That can be such a huge, what's the word I'm looking for? That can be a huge obstacle. Because you know, niggas can take over an apartment and they don't give a fuck about the people that's already there, for the most part. We're trying to get you out of here so we can get new people in here to pay a higher charge for this rent.
Mm-hmm.
So what I'm noticing now, we're in a situation now, we moving literally next week. So, them niggas just cut the air off on Monday. Don't know why, you know, they came up in here. They was like, oh, the fan broke. I was like, oh, okay. So is it any other units? Is this like for the whole apartment? Nah, just yours. I said, okay. I feel you. So then, of course, you know, you checking in.
Out of here, boy.
They bring me a bullshit little AC unit that stick in the wall. I could have got the shit from Walmart. Now, I'm not going to lie. It has done a decent job in cooling this apartment down. However, it's not the temperature that I like it, especially not in my room. I need it cold. So You know, we checked up with him throughout the week and shit. Just to see, you know, Monday passed. Okay, that's when it happened. Tuesday comes. Y'all said y'all was going to fix it the next day. Okay, it's still hot. Oh, man, you know, the part ain't come in today. We should get it in Wednesday. It should be fixed no later than Thursday. I'm like, God damn, that shit done stretched out to a whole week. Y'all be out of here by then. Keep that thought in mind. Mm-hmm. So, what happens? Thursday comes, which is when they say that the shit was supposed to be fixed indefinitely. Done. Thursday comes, it's still hot when I come in from work. Oh, man, I am pissed. So, go to the rent office. Yo, what's up with the AC? Like, y'all said y'all was gonna fix it. We'll have it fixed by tomorrow. All right. Still pissed. Tomorrow comes, Friday. Man, long week. Long ass work week. Come home. I just want to be comforted by a cold ass apartment. It's hot as fuck. So, at this point, I'm confused. Fuck y'all niggas. I'm calling corporate. So, call corporate. Blah, 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 blah. Then they, of course, they call down here. And then they give us a call. Actually, sent my mom an email. So basically, you know, the situation at hand, we apologize for any inconvenience that we may have caused you, but the part is actually still in the delivery process, and 9 times out of 10, it'll be fixed, get this, August 1st. Yo, our lease is up July 31st. So y'all telling me... Y'all motherfuckers really gonna have my air off until the day we move out and then fix the shit the next day. Yo, hey, these niggas is nasty out here, fam. Yeah. Have y'all ever had like some bullshit landlords or bullshit apartment experiences?
No, I mean, I've always stayed with my parents, so.
You've always been in the house?
Yeah. Oh, not just like, even apartment.
You like, know, my... Growing up, when I was staying with my mom or whatever, my mom was a leasing agent, so, like, she was...
Yo, what... I want an autobiography of your mom. She seems real, like, active in these streets. Like, bro, what does she not do?
Bro, my mom been through a lot, bro. Like, she
is well-rounded.
Yeah. Y'all niggas cuss?
She's a life coach and shit. Like, you know what I'm saying? So, yeah.
What is the best piece of advice she's ever given you? Stop worrying about Asia.
I know you didn't. We fighting after this.
Hey, I don't know, bro. Like, it's been so much. It's really a lot, bro. Like, my mom is really just like is the whole reason, like pretty much how, like the reason why I think the way I think. You know what I'm saying? Like. Mm-hmm. No, she like she molded that. Of course, like, you know, I have my own, you know, ideologies and all that, whatever. But like, she pretty much like instilled a lot of shit in me to where, like, you know, wisdom, pretty much.
Mm-hmm.
That's the main thing, just wisdom, for real.
That's good. I don't know, man. Getting back to my shit, I've had some very terrible apartment experiences. Like, I think at our worst, we stay in an apartment off Welcome Mall. They literally rebuilding them shits. It's like at the end by the gas station.
I know exactly what you're talking about, bro.
They used to be called, what were they called back in the day? Huh?
Was it Red Oak?
They might have renamed it since then. When I was staying there, they were called...
I know exactly what you're talking about,
I forgot
about,
what
bro.
The name of them
was. Because they right there by that Tesco, right?
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Right at the end. I forgot what the name of them shits was when I was staying
there. That fire station, right across the street.
Yeah. Oh, that was the worst experience. Like, you would have thought that the kids were like, I don't know where them kids came from, but there were like a group of kids that always play in, like, you know, them big ass dumpster things.
Mm-hmm.
Like, niggas just used, like, when niggas move out and shit, they just dump shit in there. Them niggas just used to like haul ass to the garbage and like play in the garbage for hours.
They probably had the mattresses.
No, they didn't. Oh. Box springs. Hard shit. We was like, I remember she came out on the deck. She was like, Hey kids, can y'all get out that trash? Like, you should never ask kids to get out of trash. Can y'all get out that trash? And they ran and got out the trash. My mom went back inside. 10 minutes later, I was like, Mom, they came back. Like, what the fuck is wrong with these kids? And then not only that, we had a whole, at the worst, we was
why
like,
why you snitching?
Because fuck them niggas, man. And at the worst, we was like the last people in that apartment building. And then that was bad because, like, folks would start to break in. They knew where we stayed at, but folks would, like, break in the other apartments for no reason. Probably them same kids, just, like, breaking in the houses and doing nothing. And then, of course, those doors are open and shit.
Y'all was the last motherfuckers in the apartment building?
Yeah, in one of the units. It was bad. So, bro, of course, with them doors being open, cats and dogs would, like, go in each of those rooms. So then, like, one day we noticed, we was like, what is this, like, aura of piss? What is this? Smells like strong piss. And then we start walking around into the rooms and we like, so they've just, like, started pissing and shitting and having babies in these rooms. Interesting. You go to the rent office, they act like they don't even know what the fuck you're talking about. Fam, this is in your unit right here. This is a reflection of you. I just went off on a tangent. Hey, apartments suck.
I ain't never had
yeah,
those.
Yeah, I never experienced
y'all are
it.
So fucking lucky. I don't know. Bruh. I've stayed in some decent apartments. Like this one right here, these niggas just really showed they ass. We've been living here for 10 years and they just showed they ass when they switched management like the past year.